afternoon, everybody. Yes, my name is Oksana, and I'm going to talk to you about the project that I do collaboratively with the University. It's a collaborative project between University of Sheffield and Sheffield City Council, and it involves the work that we do in four primary schools in Sheffield with high and medium density of children with EAL. So now I'm going to tell you a little bit about the project itself and what we're doing. So, these are the materials that we have developed for the project, and they are now being trialed in schools. You don't see it very well, but the main idea is we're supporting children in learning science in primary classrooms and learning science and English at the same time. The first slide is an example of the experiment and how children can record the experiments in their EL, in their lessons. The left-hand side of that slide shows you how we support children in understanding the procedures involved in experiments. So they have aim, prediction, method, results, and conclusion being explained to them in simple language, using simple language, so that they understand it. The second box there is a language support. We give them sentence starters to help them have a go at writing in English language. And the third space, obviously, there gives them an opportunity to write whatever they want to write. And because every child has his or her own booklet, they have this space and they keep the record of their achievement and they can use it later. The second slide shows you the plant here, but it is really a visual that the teacher can use to explain new concepts to the children. The visual is always labeled. On the left-hand side, there are simple definitions of the core scientific terms presented to them in English language using simple English language. And the space following these definitions is a space where children can write in their own language those definitions, the way that they understand them. They are also very welcome to write it in English language in the way that they understand it. It doesn't have to be a definition as the teacher gives it, but they can just write it the way that they want. Extra space on this page is for children to use this space to make sense of science as they understand it. They can draw or they can write. They're invited to do it in English language or in their first language. This is not an assessment material. This is a learning material, and this is for the children. So if they use a first language the teacher doesn't understand, it doesn't really matter much because they can understand and they can benefit from their own reading of their own pictures and diagrams. The next one is an example of a practical procedure where children have an opportunity to check how much they've understood of what the teacher has told them, where they have simple questions being asked to them using simple English language. And,
1 more minute.
Okay. And the right-hand side of this page can be folded to the back because it has the answers. So that once they've done the exercise, they can open it and see the answer straight away. They've done it right, well done. If they got it wrong, they can go back. And the very last page is an extra material they can take home and do a bit of homework there. And parents can help them as well because the answers are given. Parents can explain concepts in the first language. There is a link to our website where you can download these materials for free and you can use them if you want to. Okay, and that's it pretty much. Thank you very much. Thank you.